Almighty, Adama. Adama with his special walk and this almond smile. I carry the memory of his embrace like I carry the secret jewel. I am carrying his child. Well, I know it's wrong to do that before you get married, but I don't care, because all I know is that Adama loves me, and he is so very proud of me. I think his mother knows, because she treats me ever so gently. Well, I know my mother knows. I haven't told her, yet she knows. The joy that I have, and my love for Adama, shines brighter than the noonday sun on the Sahara. Oh, Adama. My love. As we walk towards the farm, we joke and laugh. The girls tease me about Adama. Don't turn round. They say, he's looking at you, and I pretend he doesn't matter. Listen, but I know, deep down in my heart, that Adama is my everything, my love, my joy, and I hope I'm carrying a man child for Adama. Well, with you, there are people who steal people, and the whole village worries about them. In the past, only few men and women were allowed to go to the farm, but now all the men come too, to protect us from the thieves of the people. When we get to the farm, a ring of bells is delicately strung around the whole perimeter of the farm. This is so the men can protect us. Oh, Adama. Harvesting is a joyous occasion. I remember it as if it was just yesterday. The noises of the farm surrounded me, and all the girls teasing me about Adama. Oh, Adama. Adama. Even Isabel to join us so we can finish before sunset. At night, the people thieves, the sledge riders abound. They came shouting, screaming, and charging down. Guy is drawn, machete is raised high. Before our men could turn on and fight, they fell on them. They took us. They stole us. And I wondered, how did they get past those rope of bells? The boat. The men were shackled below. Adam has been restrained because of the dagger. Well, I'm surprised they still haven't killed him yet. But if what we hear is true, who wouldn't want to have a man like Adam on this plantation? Some of the women tried to fight back. I chose not to, for fear of losing that which I carry within me. Child. Do you know what he did? and took you away from me. Beautiful 3-year-old daughter.
I will not talk about the thousands of lamentations. I will not talk about the families that were broken. The fear of your neighbor and the distrust of your brother. I will not go on about the brutality a nation visited upon itself. Because this is Araba's story.
I will not drown you with the sorrows of others. I will not go on about the weight of the shackles around the necks of the stolen, the taken, the lied to, the betrayed. What words can I use to describe the stench in the holds of the ship? The feeling of depression and betrayal, the smell of fear and the anger.
The anger of the men folk who were not powerful enough to protect their women folk. And the crying of our children who looked up to parents who could no longer protect them.
Thank you.
don't recall much about your grandmama, but I remember her smile. Yes, pretty lady, I remember her smile. And I think you got it. With a face like that, I feel you is trouble waiting to happen. I love you, but I hope you escape this one. They're messy and overseer, too evil. They make me wet till I bless you in the field. My shame's paid by those other women who make suck around me while Mama gets to help me birth you. They even refuse to move when the overseer tells them to. Even took a whooping from the brute because of you. When you fell to the earth, first we see you dead. In a moment, I was happy you escaped this wicked world you were so. Then you cry loud and cold, and all the women both cheered. I feel joy then. You is always happy. But your shiny black face mean you ain't never gonna be a house Negro. You gotta be plenty pleased with just working here on the farm. Your grandma's from Africa, you know. Not one of them born here Negroes who never respect the old place. She tell me who your grandpa is and what a beautiful time it is till they steal her. She teach me African song too. Don't let them catch you singing, or they'll whoop you for nothing. Sing it to your children and tell them about your grandma in Africa. Don't believe that lies about savages, you think. I know Africans stole her, but no African ever whooped her to the phone show. I know they sent me to Master Joseph's farm to pay off Master Gambling debt. The women folk here look after you. Keep your legs tight together and don't let no man in. You is pretty. Stay close to Mama Augusta. She's pure African Negro too. I hear talk say she remembered in the old ways. Even Master being messy with her.
Impact on the confidence of the man who grew up to be your husband, your brothers, your sons, and your grandsons. Royalty is sentence of craftsmen, great thinkers, landowners, and orators, now reduced to beast of burden. Your greatest asset, your greatest muscle, your brain has been made redundant.
without the permission of the master. Don't let me distract you with the story of others. Because this is Mrs. Story. Thank you.
plantation dog better Negro. You work till you is too old, then maybe you get a rocking chair. You supposed to be happy about until you die. Don't want me to see me so. When you can, my child, run. You gotta run. Run away from your new master.
You know I'm gonna run, Mama.
Oh, good. Good. Every day I tell you about the underground train there that's gonna come and take you away to freedom. But you got to know the sign. You got to listen and be ready. When you know the sign and you hear it, you go, you need me, you need everyone, you go and run.
His field. all the corn is plucked, and his land is bare and naked.
When the field of corn is plucked, and the land is bare and naked.
When his beast of burden is rested, and his barn is tied and tested.
When that beast of burden is rested, and the barn is tied and tested.
Then you can go and sleep, my sister, for the sunrise awaits you.
You can eat and sleep, my brother, for the sunrise awaits you. When beast of burden is rested and his barn is tied and tested, then you can eat and sleep, my sister, for the sunrise awaits you. Ajay, quatrequa, dope, quatrequa, dope, quatrequa, dope, quatrequa, dope. When the master's lot had feasted, upon the food we fed and grown, when the mistress child had feasted, upon my breast before my own, when that family is now rested, and we fed that duck, that bone, then we can go and feed our children. We can go and feed our own. We can go and feed our children. We can go and feed our own. We can go and feed our children. We can go and feed our own. When that family is now rested, and we fed that duck, that bone, then we can go and feed our children. When the master's lot has feasted on the food we fed and grown, when the mistress child has feasted on my breast before my young, when my family is now rested and we fed that dog that bone, then we can go and feed our children. We can go and feed our own. We can go and feed our children. We can go and feed our own.
Can go and feed our children. Can go and feed our own. Can go and feed our children. Can go and feed our own. When that family is now rested and you have fed the dog the bone, then you can go and feed your children. You can go and feed your own. And Jay, what do you want? What do you want? What do you want?
Thank you. set of nerves. It wasn't easy, but it wasn't good either. I always carry my mother's words in my heart. Run away, child! Run away to freedom. Any chance you get.
Okay, Mama.
They call her Crazy Alabama. She wasn't crazy, child. She was shy than a razor. The crop on this plantation is cotton. It's so hard to explain how picking something so soft can hurt your fingers so.
Mama?
I taught myself to read a lot, though. It was easy. My master used to send me to school with her daughter to carry her books. And I'd sit behind her in class. And when the teacher asked her a question that she couldn't answer, I'd get the cane.
Oh, Mama?
The laughing cane. So, I'll memorize the answers.
Well, that's right, Mama.
And then I'd whisper them to her, and I wouldn't get beaten. We kind of kept it to ourselves, though. Because she didn't want to appear dumb, now, did she? At times, though, she's sneaking something real nice. And I used to get all of her ugly clothes. Oh, my other saving grace on this plantation, it was an old slave called Ulysses. He said my smile made him happy.
Makes me happy too much.
I always saved a smile for him. In the evening, we'd sit in his shack. And I'd ask him to tell me stories about Africa. He'd tell me about the African kings, the queens, animal stories, and about his village, and oh, it was wonderful.
Will you tell me that, Mama?
Of course it was precious. One night, I sang a mother song to him.
Thank you.
company to sing it to your children.
Oh, Mama.
Everyone's dancing on the moon. I can feel no music, no music for soon. From the way she's moving, I know what I know. Alabama will never ever be on the road.
A lot of wicked people beat up the slaves, still go to church on Sunday, like it wasn't the same Lord who made all of us. Now don't get me wrong, it wasn't just white folk beating us. It was black beating on black too. Sometimes even white folk helping us to escape. You see, the thing is, people is just people. It comes in all kinds of packages, you know. Good and bad. So at times, the skin color doesn't even matter. But you know, the darker you is, the harder you is hit. And if you're brown, we're hanging right around. But if you black, you better stay back before you get it. Last time I went into Mr. Roosevelt's store, the fool shortchanged me, you know. When I was confronting him about it, listen to what he said. He said, 300 miles south, and a Negro wouldn't dare speak to me like that. And it appeared, lying about a note from the south, afraid? Of slaves. Years back, when times was worse, times your grandmama would sneak down south with an old habit. I would live in terror till I see her face again. And one night, she came back with an injury. No man would help her in. He was in an even worse state. He was part of that same insurrection with John Brown. And when man came down here looking, because the uprising was big news. Your grandma blessing, she just dressed man up like a woman. He was so pretty that in the morning, some nigga came calling. But by then, they was way. South is still fearsome though. Just last month, brother in Tennessee and the church in Mississippi, they burned the church, you know. A whole lot of people died. And if you were a black man, with ambitions above your station, you better be cunning too. Just last month, brother in Tennessee, broken, torn, literally slaughtered, just because some thought they saw him. Kissing a white woman. Love was never meant to hurt that much. At least here in Chicago, we can make a life of our own children. And all around you can see colored folk doing real good. Hard to believe though. As recently as a generation ago, some of these poor folk came down from Africa, hands bound in a boat. They can only buy the body. Know that, my child. They can only buy the body. Nobody can buy the mind. I shall rise. children. Make sure they don't forget it now. Say now. Don't forget it now, baby. Say like this. It was all right when he was running and winning trophies for his country. We were all right to dance and serve. No, sir. They came by our kind was too dangerous. Instead, you were supposed to be eternally grateful for the thinking of others. You've seen the Wedgwood China. The grateful slave gazing in awe at her wonderful master who set her free. Can you believe someone tried to give one of those to your father as a welcome to England present? He accidentally dropped it. Oops, he says. I think she's free now. The English are a queer folk. That single action won him some real good friends. Some are good friends now. Your godfather Ben. I remember him saying to your daddy, I want to be godfather to your daughter. She's born in America already, your daddy says. Then she'll have to have two then. And we don't have to tell the other one now, do we? He's always been your daddy's best friend. Your father was a visionary. He crossed an ocean to bring his family to a place he felt would appreciate the man he was. He fought in the Great War. But have you ever seen a statue of a brave black man in this whole damned island? He thought the English, who had appreciated his courage, beside them in the trenches, would appreciate his mind. He was wrong. Some were grateful. Some, however, didn't even want to remember that they had been helped by a person who was black, a Negro. He wanted to make a good future for his family. So somehow, he decided to stay. I remember one day, one of his students decided to challenge him. Why don't you go back home, Blackie? It was like a graduation ceremony. And the whole place went quiet. There was a sort of tension. You see, those who were close to him loved him. Those slightly further respected him. Some nursed to protest. But your father was one for drama. He raised his left hand and boomed in that magnificent voice of his. Oh, I will, he said. But first, tell me where home is. I have built this nation for over 300 years at least, forcefully or otherwise. My blood made this milk and my sweat sweetened the tea. I have carried the children and built these fortresses. My gold and diamond reside in your palaces. The bodies of my fallen have enriched this land. Find me someone more deserving to be here, and I will enter your palaces. But before him digested his words. Then there was an eruption, a most rapturous applause. Dem say still what I won't do. The supposedly stiff upper lip concealed a passion you wouldn't know. I wish he was here to see his first grandchild. But I know that he's up there somewhere, looking down. And I hope everyone is equal up there. You know your song? The one we used to sing when you were little. It's the one constant this family has owned through the passing of time. Stolen, robbed, cheated, denied, and withheld off and from everything else but that.
Since I can't recognize one word in the world saying that song. It's all in the tune. It's all in the tune, baby rabbit. He called me baby rabbit. Because that's supposed to be my African ancestor's name. It's been really ancient tune though, because I'm not yet like an African recognized it, and you work with your design university. Your great-grandpa found out so much about our past that made me proud. I know there's been sadness in the past of our family, my grandson. Tragedy of your father's death still haunts me. England is a new life that will wash away that pain that won't go away. I am the only custodian of a family tradition who's had to perform it for two generations. It's a privilege to sing this to you, but it was your father's honor. Some fool youngster, shut him! Because he stood up to protect one of his students. What's your story? Precious Lord,
When you grow up to be a man, do the best you can. Remember to be honorable.
Someday, when you find love,
find it with respect. Be your mother and father's stock. You're from good stock. Your father looked after you so well after your mother died. The boy needs a father, though. None of them do the best she can for you. God grant you life enough to grow you into a good man. This song is yours.
we love him. Your big actor daddy. Love you, daddy. Love you, daddy.
So, how was your day at the studio?
It's not been a good day at the studio, you know. I don't know what the fool was thinking. Apparently, he discovered this groovy voice.
What?
You hear me? And he had some great ideas about a tune or two that I could drop on by. Discovered this voice? Was the voice not attached to a human? Did that human not walk into that studio with a whole box of reels? Discovered this voice? Man!
Sorry, Bella. Mama's vexed.
The fool was trying to hustle me. He goes, hey, sit down, chick. We cool, you know. Then he goes, here, take a blow on this. He passes me
a joint.
No way!
Double yes way.
Oh!
Now, on the floor.
Of course, I decline. Come on, he says. You all do it that?
Don't go there. Don't even say. He says,
what?
Explain yourself, I said.
Who is this? You!
Well, he sidesteps the issue and the tech ushers me into the booth and says, let's start. No, he says, it's not right enough. We have to redo the whole thing. Sing the lyrics in this check and we'll work the sounds around it later.
Oh, he hasn't even had a rose!
What? Before I sing, I ask, do we have a deal here? He said, so I said, twinkle, twinkle, little star. I'm watching one of the talking for the sound of glass. I don't like what I'm doing on those lips. He said, let's not know there's any more valuable reel. Can you sing the songs now?
Can we talk about the deal? I said,
You tell him. Oh, he said, just sign it. It's ready in the box. He passes me the contract. He stays buzzing through it. I try with a flash.
No way, but you do.
Wait! He rolled it up and stuck it in his pocket.
We'll give you a copy later, darling, he says.
Now that's wrong.
I bailed it out. Bar, bar, bar.
Are you crazy?
No.
They might! They're furious. They rush into the booth, shouting and waving in the contract in my face. You stop listening around me, please! Burning. I can't believe that fool wanted me to spend my life
They stole us. Then they abused our children. They robbed us of our ideas, and now they want to own our minds and our thoughts. Deep, sad, and true talent didn't escape from slavery to run back into it. Anyway, it's your bedtime now, Afrochip. Sleep time, because Mama's here, and Daddy loves you. Catch you later.
Alabama's dancing on her own. She can't feel no music, poor soul. But from the way she's dancing, I know and I know that Alabama never ever be on the road. Of unequal value and visions given unequal merit and chances. I'm not here to blame anyone because
no one can write a check big enough to wipe out Holocaust. But I'm not bitter. I am triumphant. Then it is a good thing we were held back. Maybe despite the shackles, maybe without the chance, we would be angels. I'm not the first in my family lineage to want to share my music. My late mother did too, until she read her contract. So indeed, today is one of the biggest days of my musical career, but today is also one of the biggest days of my love, because my man, my strong, black, African man, proposed to me. This